warning. So we are here. What's your name?
Kiara.
Can you speak up, folks?
I said Kiara, girl.
Now you know you loud. She trying to pretend. So we are currently in Atlanta, about to get on the plane. My birthday is Sunday. Today is Thursday, December 9th. I don't know if I'm going to make this one video or if I'm going to do day by day, because y'all know that I suck at posting already. So I'm going to do my best. I don't know. It depends on how the video goes. If the video be too long, then I do day by day. But if not, then I do.
I think day by day should be the plan.
I mean, yeah. But it be the editing. I never get to edit because we're going to see. If I'm not that drunk tonight, then I will edit. But if I am, then whatever.
Y'all, did my own hair. It don't look that bad.
Don't even know what I be doing. But yes, so we are going to Miami for my birthday.
In 2 miles, take exit 239 onto Charles, West Grand Parkway toward US 41.
Thank you so much. But yes, and we're going to be here from Thursday till Monday. The plan is tonight we're going, what are we doing tonight? We're going to go to the Airbnb, and then we're going out to eat tonight. Then we're going to go to a bar, club, whatever. Tomorrow, what are we doing tomorrow?
We got a lot going on, so that's why I say day by day.
You're right. We should do this day by day, because I don't even know what we're doing. So, yeah, but we got our bags. Well, that's my big suitcase. Her carry-on. My carry-on. Her other suitcase in the trunk. We packed light this time, because I always pack. I always pack too much, but yeah, so I'm excited. We're gonna be on time for the flights.
Too
very proud,
cause it delayed.
Yeah, the flight delayed. It was on delay by like 15 minutes though, so I'm not too upset. But yeah, so I'll be back when we get on the plane.
We parked the car at a hotel, and then we took a shuttle to the airport. And our nails were super cute, by the way.
Okay, so I'm gonna have to explain a little bit. So, we ended up missing our flight, for starters. I was super upset about it, because when we first walked to the little kiosk to check in, mind you, the little Delta lady, she was being real rude. Well, she wasn't being rude, she was just being like, you know how people treat you like you already supposed to know something? And I'm like, okay. So, she was talking to me like I should already knew how to do the kiosk thing. And I don't think I went through that when I flew Delta in Nashville. You know, every airport is different. I still ain't got my smoke detector sticks, by the way. But anyway, yeah. So, it wouldn't let me check in. So, I was like, excuse me, ma'am, what's going on, blah, blah, blah. She was like, well, that means you're too late. Your flight is already boarding. So, you can't get on your flight if it's already boarding, because you still ain't went through security. So I'm over here like, what does that mean? So she was like, you're gonna have to get another flight. And I was like, oh my god, this ain't gonna work. It's already going bad. And I've had my share of bad luck in my life. So when one thing starts off wrong, I automatically just think it's horrible, we're not gonna be able to do it, blah blah blah. So I'm stressing out, of course. And my friend Kiara, she was like, no, it's okay, we're just gonna get another. She was being very positive about it, because she knows how much this trip meant to me. So why do they sound like they're louder? Like, what's going on? But she knew how much this trip meant to me. So the fact that we have to, like, it's starting off bad, we have to get there. I've never had to reschedule my flight. Like, I've always been on time. But the lady who was talking to us told us, you know, you normally supposed to show up 2 hours before your flight time. And I'm like, I've never showed up 2 hours before my flight time, maybe 45 minutes, chilling the little wait area for a little minute. But I've never shown up 2 hours prior to my flight time. Yes, I broke 2 nails. But yeah, so we ended up having to go to the customer service, talk to the people about getting us on another flight. And the lady was like, well, we don't have any available right now. We're going to have to put you on standby for the next flight. And standby is when you basically get put on a wait list. And if people don't show up to their flight, then you take their seats. And so At first, I was like, who else ain't gonna show up today? Flight. Then again, I was like, we're in Atlanta. It's possible. Traffic, you know, other circumstances or whatever, they might be late too. Because there was a lot of other people in the customer service line that were late to their flight. So it was possible, but like I said, once something negative happens in my mind, it's just like, this ain't gonna work. We're gonna have to cancel the whole trip. I done paid for all this stuff. You know, just a whole bunch of negative stuff. And I gotta stop doing that. 2022, we not being negative no more. So yeah, we end up getting on the standby flight. And while we were sitting there waiting, I saw this little white man. He was like older. He was like, I'll say close to 50. Maybe late 40s, mid-40s, maybe mid-40s. But he was telling me that he was from California. I was just thinking, sugar daddy. So he was telling me he was from California. He was coming on a business trip, and he was talking to us. Like, we could try to make conversation. He first asked my friend for her charger, and then he just kept going with the conversation and asking us what we were doing. Was this our first time going to Miami? And all this other stuff. And baby, he had a first-class flight. So I said, money. So yeah, he has like a brown leather suitcase with a briefcase. I said, oh, he's coming for business. I said, oh, you got a free trip, honey. You get all your expenses paid. But yeah, so I don't really know how to approach people, ask for their number, or try to see how far they gonna go with that. So I just let it go. But he was really nice. So when we end up getting on the flight, we had saw him again. And he took his headphones out when he saw us walking up, girl. He was like, he said something. I don't know what he said. But I was just like, yeah, we made it. And I was trying to be all flirty. I was like, where's the money? So yeah, whatever. But we ended up getting on a flight, and the flight was real chill. Okay, this is the living room, kitchen, dining, desk, kitchen, bathroom. Only thing is, I don't understand why there is no curtain to this window. And then my room, and Kiera's getting dressed, so we're not gonna show her room right now. But we are about to get dressed and go to Joa Beach restaurant. I gotta fix my head, and yeah.
When you get there, it is so pretty. It sits on a beach, obviously, and it's very ducked off, and you get to see yachts pass by, and it's just such a pretty atmosphere.
And we serve this Mr. John.
We ordered the chicken thighs and potatoes because their menu is a little expensive, but they were so good.
You cannot see me because it is super dark out here, but we are at Joa Beach. I think that's how you say it. I'll post my plate. Yes.
I'm a black girl.
Everyone looks black, except the not black people. But this chicken.
It's not barbecue sauce, but it's demi glaze. So
that sounds
demi
good. Glaze. The demi glaze. It
looks
like syrup.
Oh no.
That's different.
No, hold on.
Oh no.
We went back to the house to change into something more comfortable before we headed to South Beach. The city was super pretty overall. The streets were like so big, everything was over water, and we end up deciding to go to this place called Voodoo Rooftop Bar and Lounge.
Yeah.
your hands out.
Okay. What was I saying? Hey, so it's some people that stay next door, right? So the way the Airbnb, damn, my head big. The way the Airbnb is set. Maybe I can put it over here. Okay, it don't matter. Fuck it. Well, say bleed anyway. So it's a house next door, and I asked the man, and he said that it was a studio house, but it didn't belong to us. It was guests there, so we just pulled up. Well, no cars out there earlier, but now it's a red. Is it a Challenger? I don't know cars. That's a Challenger sitting out there. So I think it's a man, but we in like a Mexican type neighborhood. I look spooky, like I'm telling a ghost story. It's like we in a Mexican type neighborhood, which I don't have a problem with that. But, you know, I just think they Mexican. But yeah. So that's what I had to say. What was the purpose of me doing
this? We would
this?
See y'all.
We would no, we gotta tell them what we did. It's already on my mind. So we had went to Voodoo. This is Prescott Voodoo. I don't even know why we went in there with the name like
I'm
that.
I'm not gonna tell
them
what's going on.
No, we just was drinking and stuff. I don't know why she has a flash on her face, but we said that's because we
you just said turn the light on.
It's okay, but we're tired. So
we'll see y'all.
So tomorrow we're supposed to get up early. We'll see what that happened. We'll see how that happens. Get up early. Go to the store. We have to get up and go to the Sam's, to the beauty spa store, and one other place. I forgot. But we have to go there.
Breakfast date.
Y'all, we met some Mexicans.
Some
Mexicans. And this motherfucker, I mean this boy, he said this boy bought 4 Patron shots, because I had already bought me a Patron shot. So he saw me drinking. So he was like, what you drinking? Let me take a shot with you. So he had bought me, her, him, and his other friend Patron shots. Took shots with us, y'all. He was talking my ear off. But he asked me, have I been to Bacon B before? And I told him no. But I told him we were supposed to go Sunday for my birthday brunch. And he said, no, we're going tomorrow. So I'm going to text him tomorrow if I remember.
We're going to Bacon what?
Bacon B word. So good. This is day number one. Then we met some more. They're not white. They're like
mine.
I don't know what their ethnicity is. I don't think.
But they're amazing.
I don't know.
People.
But yeah, they're really cool.
A lot of sugar daddies on the way. We live.
I'm gonna be on somebody's boat on Sunday. That's all I know.
And so we will see y'all tomorrow.
I'm really tired.
But later on.
Yeah, later on, because it's 2:03 in the morning. It's 3 in the morning.
Peace out.
Peace out. A-Town.
We in Miami, bitch.
Oh, we're in Miami. They don't have a saying. Did they ever say
peace out?
City girls from the 3
Body Sculpture by Miami.
Body Sculpture. That's what I need to do for my birthday.
Dr. Miami.
So I see money and get a BBL. All right, peer pool, let's go.